Stereolithography has been around since the mid-1980s, so it's really the veteran of additive manufacturing technologies. And this technology is still going strong today. Simply put, it produces great-looking models with impeccable surface quality and fast turnaround time. That's why SLA is a popular technology in the art and design industry, in the automotive market for concept and showcase components, and in architecture for detailed models. Let's take a look at how it works. Also known as SLA and SL, stereolithography is a laser-based technology that uses a UV-sensitive liquid resin. A UV laser beam scans the surface of the resin and selectively hardens the material corresponding to a cross-section of the product. Then the magic happens, and the 3D part is built from the bottom to the top. The support structures are automatically generated to hold up overhangs and gaps in parts. Later on, these are removed manually. SLA is the go-to technology for larger, single-build prints. At Materialize, we have developed our own patent mammoth stereolithography machines. These machines enable us to 3D print parts up to 2 meters long in a single build. That's the size of an entire car bumper. Stereolithography is one of the most widely used rapid prototyping technologies for plastic models, including for those with complex geometries. Printing masters for copying techniques such as vacuum casting is another ideal application for stereolithography, as is making visual prototypes for photo shoots and market testing. SLA is well suited to produce a wide range of applications, from visual prototypes to patterns for investment casting. The materials available for stereolithography differ mainly in color, strength, stiffness, and impact strength. White, black, translucent, and transparent objects can be realized, and the components can feature complex, functional details or parts with comparatively high thermal resistance. When you start designing for SLA, there are a few key points to keep in mind. 1. With SLA, your wall thickness depends on the overall part size. So always remember to increase the wall thickness whenever you scale up your design. 2. Hollow parts to keep costs down and avoid issues with shrinkage in thicker sections. 3. Some cavities will need supports inside. Be sure to take this into account in your design, particularly if your part is transparent and they will need to be removed later. And that's stereolithography in a nutshell. It's an oldie, but a goodie, a great go-to for when you want to get great-looking models printed in a flash.